Hey, welcome to Half the Battle, and welcome to our first look at the Dreadnoks, specifically Buzzer.
The Dreadnoks were a mercenary biker gang led by Zartan in the G.I. Joe universe, and they very much resembled stereotypical bikers. The first ones did anyway. One of the original three was Buzzer. His toy was released in 1985 with all original body parts. Note that his head can only turn left and right, not up and down. This is sorta strange, since most figures from 1985 already had a ball joint in their neck. Only the Dreadnoks and Tollbooth didn't, meaning they were designed in 1984 and could be holdovers from that year. The figure certainly looks the part, a mean biker. He's got a cool ponytail, made out of plastic, not one of those ridiculous real-looking ones that came later. He also has some cool shades. I particularly like his snarly facial expression. He does have one hell of a widow's peak, though, rivaling that of cartoon Airtight. One interesting thing I found is his shirt. Though it's sleeveless, it closely resembles the one Duke wears, down to the colors and everything, only more or less mirrored. It's probably a coincidence, but it adds a nice what-if factor. Now we come to his accessories. Like all figures from G.I. Joe's Golden Age, they are great-looking and appropriate. He's got a cool-looking chainsaw and a vicious, lethal-looking flail with a blade. His backpack is functional, since it's a gas can for his chainsaw, or perhaps even a motorbike. The only bad thing I can say about it is, well, the gas can is removable, but it's hollow. I would have preferred it if it was a solid piece of plastic. Also, I question the wisdom of running into battle with such a flammable thing strapped to your back. Now, these accessories are pretty great, but there's an even more awesome accessory available. For that, we have to go outside of G.I. Joe for a moment. In fact, we have to go outside of Hasbro even, to a little toy line that featured G.I. Joe-like toys, the Core. Now, most figures and accessories from this line were pretty subpar when compared to G.I. Joe.
One accessory, however, stands out and should by all rights be Buzzer's.
I present to you a triple-headed freaking chainsaw gun. This is the most metal thing I've ever seen that fits G.I. Joe figures. Hard rock hallelujah! It's completely impossible, but damn if I don't want the Mythbusters to try and build one. I suggest tracking this thing down and strapping it to your Buzzer figure.
Speaking of accessories, you know what I always thought was a real shame? The Dreadnoks are a motorcycle gang, so you figure that they would have bikes, but G.I. Joe never gave them motorcycles in the toy line.
This is it, the Dreadnought Cycle.
Watch out, Joe, cause trouble awaits you. The Dreadnought Cycle's gonna devastate you.
The Dreadnought Cycle has a swivel machine gun that carries four Dreadnought.
That doesn't count.
And this was the only toy Buzzer ever got in the original line. Yeah, I've ranted about this sort of thing before, so let's just let that rest, shall we? I will talk about one more version of him that came out later, in 2005. Though, there's not that much to talk about, really. It's a repaint of the original figure, but with a new head sculpt. It's a good update. The new color scheme is nice, his head is more detailed, and they toned down the Widow's Peak considerably. His accessories are the same as the original, only in black.
With the toys out of the way, it's time to talk about his character. And I have to say, straight off the bat, that this guy has one of the most interesting backstories in the whole G.I. Joe line.
He used to be an extreme left-wing don or tutor at Cambridge University in England. He went to Australia to study biker gangs and got enthralled by them so much, he ended up joining the Dreadnoks, unlocking his hidden desires for anarchy and destruction.
I mean, wow! This guy is fascinating! You could make an entire movie about him alone!
The file card even infers that his love of chainsaws comes from a desire to tear apart society's technology, mostly in the form of G.I. Joe vehicles. In the comic, his file card persona is somewhat preserved. Unlike other dreadnoughts, Buzzer is inclined to talk in a posher and more sophisticated way, and he's unable to control himself when the opportunity for destruction arises. He also seems to be the guy that takes charge of the dreadnoughts when Zartan isn't around. He did some interesting things in the comic. In fact, he was responsible for Cobra learning the location of G.I. Joe headquarters, the Pit. Something that you'll know if you watch my comic reviews is very high on Cobra's list of priorities. You see, Buzzer got captured by the Joes, was taken to the Pit, and later escaped, meaning he could tell Cobra about the location. The other, let's say, notable thing he did involves something you don't often see in media like this. He took a chainsaw to a dog.
Dude, that's cold, man. That's ice cold.
Yeah, this is sort of a weird phenomenon, isn't it? In comics, or even cartoons, you can mow down people like they're leaves of grass, but attack a puppy and you just crossed a line.
The dog recovered, by the way, so don't worry.
So now we come to the cartoon version of Buzzer. As some of you may have watched one of my earliest reviews, the one that dealt with the episode Cobra's Candidate.
If you did, well, first of all, you poor, poor bastards. Those first videos sucked. Secondly, you know what's coming next. This is how a Cambridge tutor was represented in the cartoon.
Oh, come on, mate. Cobra Commander knows I can't read.
If it was just this episode, might have assumed that it just got Torch, who actually is illiterate, and Buzzer mixed up accidentally. But if you look at their other appearances, all dreadnoughts are dumb as bricks, and their personalities are only defined by the type of weapon they use. Yeah, basically, this guy is Cobra's equivalent of Bazooka in the cartoon. Another interesting and compelling character that gets completely lobotomized simply to have a humorous effect. Hey, Gimli, how have you been?
Weak. Yeah, the cartoon really screwed the pooch when it came to this guy.
So that was Buzzer. Now, before I get to the conclusion, I have a confession to make.
I didn't like the dreadnoughts when I first encountered them. You have to understand, I was introduced to the toys first, before I ever saw the cartoon or read the comics.
And I was introduced to G.I. Joe with the 1985 series. You had these great-looking military guys like Footloose and Dusty fighting against these really slick-looking bad guys in spiffy uniforms. And then you had these gruffy hoodlums that didn't really fit in anywhere. I just thought they looked really out of place.
It wasn't until I started getting into the cartoon and comics that I appreciated them.
Anyway, conclusion. As far as the toys go, while the original is great, I prefer the 2005 version for two reasons. Less of a widow's peak, and he's made of a softer plastic, so it's less likely you'll damage his thumbs when putting a weapon in them. Also, I repeat, track down that triple chainsaw gun. Hard rock hallelujah, baby! As far as the character goes, well, he's certainly the most interesting dreadnought, and even one of the most interesting characters in G.I. Joe, period. Very nicely done to Hasbro and Larry Hama. Screw the cartoon, though. And, well, that's about it for Buzzer. This means we're done with the letter B on my show.
Just 24 letters to go! Yeah, we're really cruising through them, aren't we?
Actually, you know, I think it's time I shook things up a little. You see, if I continue to go alphabetically, we're gonna hit an awful lot of characters that start with the word Cobra. So, I'm gonna be a bit more random from now on.
That's right, you'll never again be sure what's coming next. Well, see you next time, everybody!
I'm a bee, 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 I'm a bee.